Charbel has asked, with the rotary, I've heard running lean can cause detonation. Does this mean we run slightly rich to keep it safer? I'm really keen to hear your thoughts on differences for rotary tuning. Yeah, 100%. There are some idiosyncrasies with the rotary engine. Interestingly, despite the fact that the operating principle of the rotary engine is completely different to a piston engine, they actually respond in a very similar way to tuning. However, you've hit the nail on the head there. Rotary engines, typically, we will run them a little bit richer, quite a bit richer than a comparable piston engine. And they also need to be very mindful of ignition timing, because rotary engines are very intolerant of almost any level of detonation. We can easily damage an apex seal if we end up with the engine suffering from knock. So the aim of the tuning process here is to be conservative with our ignition timing. There are a couple of other idiosyncrasies with the rotary engine. They run staged injection, so we need to account for that. And they also have a leading and trailing spark plug, so they have a trailing split ignition timing map as well. Now, we actually have an FD3S RX7 project car that we've just recently got up and running on the Adaptronic modular ECU, and we will be adding a complete worked example into our practical standalone tuning course very shortly on the Adaptronic ECU, but we've already got some members' webinars in our archive covering the rotary trailing split and the staged injection. So for rotary fans out there, don't worry, we've got you covered. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.